I'm here at the lovely Beckman Street Deli in Glandore, and I've just wrapped up another meeting accompanying one of my local constituents from Glandore, who is unfortunately facing the heartbreaking reality that her home is being compulsorily acquired. It was her first meeting with the DIT officials, and I was more than happy to be there to support her in asking some questions and getting some clarity about what's going to happen from here on in. I thought it might be a good time to share a few tips with you if you are about to have your first meeting with the Department of Transport. My first tip is take someone with you. It's handy to have someone there to take a few notes for you, to ask a few questions that you might not get to or might not think of in the heat of the moment, and also for a bit of emotional support. It is a pretty raw thing when you're actually sitting down with the officials in front of you to realise that the government is taking your home. And you may really want someone to have a chat with afterwards or even during the meeting, just to give you that extra little bit of support. You can take anyone you like. You can take your neighbour, you can take a friend, you can take a family member. You can take a lawyer if you feel like forking out for them. Or of course, you can take your local MP, me, especially if you're someone who's vulnerable or you don't have anyone else who can come with you. And I'd be more than happy to do that for you. My next tip is to get a specialist land acquisition lawyer. You can go it alone and you don't have to have a lawyer, but I would strongly recommend that you do get a lawyer. Your legal fees will be either in full or part compensated for, so you may as well take advantage of that if it's not going to cost you anything or much. There are specialist lawyers who look after land acquisition. Not all lawyers are the same, so make sure you find one that knows what they're doing in this area. If you'd like a list of the lawyers that are specialists in land acquisition, just give me a call or send me an email and I'll send you through the shortlist and you can make your choice from there. Now, lawyers do give a free 30-minute consultation, and that's the time when you might want to ask them about costs and how they operate and what experience they've got in this area. My next tip is don't get your own valuation yet. Especially if you're going to see a lawyer, make sure you have a chat with them first and wait until the government has appointed its independent valuer to come and look at your property. And then you can assess whether you want to get a valuation and who you want to do that. Your lawyer will be able to advise you of good valuers in town who'll do the right thing by you. Talk with your neighbours. You know, it's a beautiful community here. We're all going through similar or the same things with South Road being built. So do have a chat with your neighbour. Whether you're staying or you're going or they're going or staying, it's a really good thing to just have a chat, give each other some emotional support, and also swap some information as well. Look after yourself. It's really important to look after your own mental health at this time. This news will come differently to different people, and it's really important that you keep in check your mental health and look after yourself first. The department can wait. Your mental health is the most important thing. So if you need to put a few meetings off, do that. Don't rush. You don't need to rush into this process at all. And if you are really struggling, there are mental health services available for free. So just get in contact with me and I can tell you how to access those services to give you a bit of support at this really difficult time. And lastly, if you're at a loss as to what to do or where to go, call your local MP. Give me a call and I can point you in the right direction. And if I can't answer your question, I'll find the answer for you. It's really important that you let me know what's going on as well, because if the same thing is happening to a number of us that's not fair, then I can go and raise that publicly, and that's exactly what I've been doing. So last week, you guys told me about how the government was telling you that they wanted you to sign off on land acquisitions within 3 months, and then they wanted you to pay market rent. Within 48 hours, we got that changed. I went out and spoke to the media, spoke to the department, and we got that changed. So I can help you in making sure that this system is fairer for all of us. I look forward to talking to you soon, and good luck with those initial meetings.